Hi, welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at workflows and file formats, and particularly this option when saving, preserve Illustrator editing capabilities. So this is in the SVG options, but it also exists in other file formats. So let's cancel that. Now, I've saved this file as an AI file, and let's take a look at what's in it. So we've got a point text here and a path text, and there's a brush stroke. We've got a linked file, an area text, and two boxes that have effects applied. So let's go to the appearance panel, and you've got the drop shadow here. So this is the drop shadow from the stylize menu. And then we've got in here the SVG filter shadow, which is in effects SVG filters. Let's close this, and maybe you have different demands in your workflow and you want to save this in a different file format. So this is a native file, and using a native file format for Illustrator, I can be sure that I can edit everything again, provided I'm working in the same version and I don't save this down. So let's now save this as an SVG. And maybe you've heard that when saving SVGs, you go to Export for Screens because that produces the most modern code. So let's go to Export for Screens, and then let's select SVG from here and export this artboard. There it is, and let's close this one. And now let's see what we got. So the artboard is there. And let's open this in Illustrator again, because maybe you want to continue editing. And let's see. And you see there are already changes because the shadows are gone. This is no longer an area text, so I can no longer select all of this. Also, this is no longer a path text. This is no longer a brush. The image is still linked, but also this is not even a point text anymore. These are multiple point texts, so editing will be hard and you will have to redo a lot of what's in this file. So obviously that doesn't work. Let's take a look at some options we would have. So first let's open the original file again. So I'm going to my file, and then let's go to Export for Screens, and let's take a look at the options. You can find them under this cogwheel, and let's see what SVG has to offer. But there's nothing in here that can preserve the editing, so won't work that way. Now we've got another method to save SVGs, which is in File and Save As. And there you can choose SVG and then go into these options. And there we have Preserve Illustrator Editing Capabilities. Usually this is turned off because it makes a larger file. We can see that in a moment. We've got some more options in here. You see there are a couple of more options, but let's just leave it as that and go to OK. So let's close that, and then let's take at file sizes. So this is 10 kilobytes. And let's take a look at the other one. Let's go to the options, and you see this is 300. So it's quite a bit more. Now, how does Illustrator do that? So you can also see that it has saved this thing here. It wasn't there before. So this looks like a shadow. Now, why that? Okay, let's take a look at this file. So when I just double click it, it will be opened in whatever editor I have associated with the SVG file format. And when I'm doing that, you see it opens in Inkscape, which I have installed on this computer. And there we have the content of the file, and you see it's everything there, like so. Let's just close this for a moment. And When I want to make sure to open that in Illustrator, I need to take this and drag this over the Illustrator icon or go to Open. And in here, you see we have the path text and we have the original font. And there's the area text, and these are still effects, and even the brush is still alive. So let's close that again. And let's open this again in Inkscape. So I'm going to double click it, and you see there it is. It's obviously grouped, so let's go to ungroup. And let's see, it's still grouped, so let's go to layers and objects, which is the layers panel basically, and let's see, there it is, so still grouped. And let's take a look at everything. So let's go to ungroup again, and there we are. So it's this object, and you see it's a rectangle, and when I turn that off, it takes the effect with it. So that's the one with the SVG effect, and it's live in Inkscape. Let's go to this one, and you see that one has an image. And when I turn that off, well, that is the shadow, and that's the thing Illustrator saved on my desktop. So let's go in here, and we've got an area text. But this brush is, of course, not live, and this is a path text. And also, we have a text here. So let's go in here and change some things. So let's select this and let's see and make this red. And also we've got the final text. So let's have the final text here, like so. Okay. Some text, and that's okay like so. And now we're going to save this, and we're going to close it as well. And then let's go back to Illustrator with it. And you see, we've got a problem. There's now our edits in here. But you see the shadow is gone and everything else is gone too. Now, that's kind of weird what has happened here, because it was there previously. So, and now it's gone. Let's take a look at something else to finally get an understanding of what this option does. So let's take a look at the file size, and you see the file is still quite large. Let's open this again, and we're going to save this as a PDF, like so. And again, in the PDF dialog box, we can turn on Preserve Illustrator Editing Capabilities. So let's save the PDF and go out of here. And to edit a PDF, of course, we can go to Acrobat. And in there, we can also edit the PDF. Let's go into the editing mode. And maybe let's have some other text in here, like so. Okay, and let's see if we can move this around like so. We can rotate it, and then we have these, and maybe what else can we do? Let's change the color of that text. Okay, so close the editing and save the file. Again, Same thing as with the SVG, we can just drag this now over Illustrator, and then let's see what we can get. So, going to open and OK. And then you see the edits are gone. Let's go out of here and let's drag this over Acrobat again, and the edits are there. So this is now the explanation of what's happening. When you check this option, Preserve Illustrator Editing Capabilities, then Illustrator creates two files in one. And when you open this in a different editor, then with Acrobat, the PDF is opened. And when you do that with Illustrator, the AI file is opened. So let's go into Illustrator again, like so. And we now make some editings, and maybe we haven't even registered that someone has edited this file in Acrobat. We didn't notice. So let's make some edits and then let's save this. And now I'm going to open it again in Acrobat, and you see the edits that were previously in this file are now gone because I have edited it in Illustrator, and when Illustrator saved it, it also updated the PDF part of the file with the new content. So this is quite dangerous, actually. And I'm going to take this PDF and open it in Affinity Designer. So it gets imported. There we have the file. And we can move this around. Of course, the effects are expanded and the text is no longer there. Let's make some edits to that, like so. And then let's also save this. And I'm going to cancel that, and I'm just going to save it, just like that. But Affinity Designer wants to save as, which is nice. So that way I won't automatically ruin my original file. So let's just save it. And then let's close it. And there is my file. So this is now Affinity Designer file. So I need to save as, or rather export this in order to get a PDF. So let's export that and make a PDF. And then let's close this and go to the PDF and going back to Illustrator, like so. And you see now, let's go into outline view. So the text is still there, but we don't have any live effects anymore, and the brush is gone, and everything is kind of difficult to edit. So as a conclusion of all this, all these file formats like SVG and PDF, and this also applies to EPS, are not really suitable for this kind of workflow to exchange back and forth, and also to edit in two different places, in two different apps. And particularly SVG is a one-way street in Illustrator. So while working on a file, you're safe when editing it as an AI file, and then when you're done, export it. And better never open it again in Illustrator. So when you want to edit, go back to your original native work file. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.